Jesus loves us. Thank you, Lord God. Yes. Oh, what a love. Come on, just bask in that. Bask in it.
Because
light to us. Thank you, Lord.
Give him honor and we give him glory. Yeah. in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I give God praise because, hallelujah, myself, I give praise because I built my elder, Dr. Walker over there, we do not talk about the word that's going forward and what songs is going to be ministered. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. But today, hallelujah, as I sought God, as I sought God and toiled and trying to articulate what was on the heart of God, the series is coming forward. The title of this is Bring Forth Your Love. Hallelujah.
Bring.
Somebody say, Bring Forth Your Love.
Bring
forth your love in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
And I begin to look at this thing as God, that the matters of the heart, in the midst of everything that the world is going through, the United States is going through, locally, county, the federal, state, and federal authorities, and those type of things, God is still required for his love to be brought forward into the name.
Amen.
And we begin to look, one can look at everything that's happening and look at the news on the secular side. And one can look on the spiritual side and begin to look at this thing. And as we try to reconstitute, as we begin to try to regroup after, as it seems as though that the pandemic is going down, we're trying to group and regather. Hallelujah. As we begin to look at the situation, hallelujah, we just look forward and God is saying, bring forth my love. Hallelujah.
Amen.
See, because God said, be instant in season and what? Out of season. Hallelujah.
Yes.
When you feel like it and when you don't. Hallelujah. Bring forth my love in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God said, bring forth my love. You might not understand it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, but Jesus said, hallelujah, it's a mandate from heaven.
Yeah.
Thank God that God's mandate cannot be shut down. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Pandemic cannot shut down a mandate. Thank God. Hallelujah. A mandate from God is not shut down because something happens in the earth.
Thank God. Thank you, Lord God.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank God that we can hear the clarion call. The Lord said, bring forth. Hallelujah. My love. Hallelujah. And for us, hallelujah, we're crying out as a preacher, hallelujah, bring forth your love. Or for us to bring forth the love of God to the nations.
Yes.
And then as a second thought, this is just a parenthetical phrase here. God said, where is the love? Somebody say, where is the love? My God, where is the love in the name of Jesus? And when I heard it in the spirit, where is the love? I said, God, what are you talking about? Where is the love? Where are we? Where is the love in the name of Jesus? And the Lord, as we begin this series, hallelujah, God is saying, love must be received first. First we receive it. Then love is reciprocated, hallelujah. It's given back to daddy. It's love is not complete until giving is taken place, until it's released back to daddy. Hallelujah. We have no love of ourselves. Love was demonstrated and released to us from heaven. Hallelujah. The agape love. Hallelujah. Agape love is supernatural. And God is saying it to us. Hallelujah. God is saying it must be reciprocated, embraced, and then demonstrated. Hallelujah. Love must be received, reciprocated, embraced, and demonstrated. Hallelujah. Love is not complete until giving takes place in the name of Jesus. For God so loved us that he what? Gave, hallelujah, his only begotten son.
Amen.
And we look at this, the principle that's going to govern us today is unconditional love. Hallelujah. Unconditional love is God's plan to keep us from failing. Hallelujah. Because 1 Corinthians 13:8 says, love never fails. Hallelujah. Agape never fails. But whether there are prophecies, they will fail. Whether there be tongues, they will cease. Whether there is knowledge, it will vanish away. Hallelujah. But when God said, bring forth your love, God is saying, It's a love that will never fail. It's agape. Somebody say agape.
Agape.
Bring forth this love. It's unconditional, not based on conditions. It's not based on whether you like me or not. It's not based on what somebody has done. It's not based on the characteristics of the circumstances that we may find ourselves in our situation. God said, love never what? Fails.
Never fails.
Love never fails. Thank God. Hallelujah. Bring forth my love. Hallelujah. See, the objective is how to have good success. If love never fails, that means love, there's a way that we can have good success with God and with man. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Good success with God, hallelujah, and the horizontal relationship with mankind in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And the goal is how to have victory. When God's talking about bring forth, hallelujah, bring forth my love. The goal of love is how to have victory over evil circumstances, or even in the midst of evil circumstances. Hallelujah. We still can have victory. John 16:33 reminds us that these things Jesus spoke, these things I've spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation. But then he gives us a good one. He said, but be of good cheer.
Yeah.
I have overcome the world. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
We're talking about bringing forth a love that overcomes. Hallelujah. Yeah. In spite of, hallelujah, in the midst of, hallelujah, regardless of what's happening, we begin to release the love of God, hallelujah, to the earth, to the nations, in Jesus' name. As we begin to go forward, we're talking about bringing forth the love of God, hallelujah. The love is spoken of, hallelujah, in both the Old and the New Testament. The Old Testament in Deuteronomy 6 and Matthew 22. But what I want you to do is just as you prepare yourself, we are going, the context of this word will come from 1 John, hallelujah. 1 John 4, 7 through 11. Hallelujah. 1 John 4, 7 through 11. But God began to tell us in Deuteronomy, as we begin to start the series, I just wanted to set this thing up. God began to tell us, Deuteronomy 6, 4 and 5, he says, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. Listen, the only Lord. And you shall love the Lord your God with all your mind and heart, with your entire being and with all your might. Hallelujah. This is Deuteronomy 6. Hallelujah. This is Hebrew. You fast forward in the New Testament. Hallelujah. As God began to deal with a Sadducee, they wanted to know what is the greatest commandment. Hallelujah. And Jesus began to open up the door of what's the greatest commandment is. Matthew 22:37-40. Hallelujah. Jesus replied to the Sadducee person. He said, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all of your soul, and with all of your mind. Intellect is amplified. This is the great, most important principle in the first commandment. And then he goes on to say, and a second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as you do yourself.
Yeah.
And then he goes on to say, these two commandments sum up. Listen, and upon them depend all the law and the prophets. Another verse says, hang the law and the prophets. This thing about loving God with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. The Lord God is one. It's one God, and God demonstrated his love. The love of God was released to the earth, which is Jesus Christ. Somebody say Jesus Christ the righteous. My God, my God. These two commandments. Now see, God's like, you cannot fail. Listen. But then God gave us, God began to identify, and he began to give us the love wherewith we can love him back. Hallelujah. This is not love that we draw up. It's nothing that we come up with ourselves. Hallelujah. God said, I know what I want you to demonstrate to me and to the earth. Hallelujah. But listen, I'm going to give you the money. Listen, I'm going to give you the gift. I know what I want. Hallelujah.
My God, come on.
I know what you need and creation need at this point for salvation, to deliver you from the hands of the devil. Hallelujah. To deliver your soul from iniquity. See, God began to deal with us as the greatest commandment. Oh, see, that's why God said, I will keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on me.
Hallelujah.
See, there are a lot of things that's important. I know that we have a lot of things going on, but the most important, the greatest commandment, hallelujah.
My God, come on.
God said, I need your mind on me, hallelujah. My mind must be on him.
Yes.
Yeah. See, you can be in a place, you can go, you can be in church, and your mind can be somewhere else.
Yes, help us.
My God, you can be on your knees trying to pray to God, and the cares of this life, your mind can be, what am I going to eat next week?
Wow.
Do I have any witnesses in the place? And see, the enemy is always trying to get to our mind.
Yes.
The soulless realm. We can be in a place of hurt, a place of despair. And what began to happen when we begin to see God? We can't see God for we can't see him because of the hurts.
Come on, preach.
And God is saying, keep regardless of anything. Hallelujah. Broke, busted, disgusted. Huh? Put your mind on me. Hallelujah. Come running to Daddy in the name of Jesus. Love him with all of your might, with all of your strength. Hallelujah. Everything that's in you.
Yes. Amen.
Because it's going to pay out, it's going to pay dividends in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Yes.
Eternal dividends. This ain't going to set us on a plain path. God has the ability to bring us in a place of prosperity, a place of warfare, a place of productivity, a place where we, where a fruitfulness, where we can bear fruit in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
So let's look at this. And we start this series, and God began talking about, bring forth my love. First, we're going to identify this love, that God is saying. Let's go right now. Let's go to 1 John, the 4th chapter. 1 John, the 4th chapter. I'm going to be reading out of the Amplified Version. Amplified Version of the Bible. And I believe God has something to say to us. For those of us, different ones, getting weary, in this walk. Somebody, you get weary. God wants to bring some encouragement to us. It's not profound. This is not profound, but it's needed. The word has a way of strengthening us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 1 John, the 4th chapter, and the 7th verse. Actually, this is New King James Version, this part right here. And it says it like this. It says, beloved, let us love one another. For love is of God. Love is of God.
Yeah.
And everyone who loves is what? Born of God and knows God. Verse 8. He who does not love does not know God. For God is what? God is love.
God is love.
Hallelujah. And then verse 9 says, this is, I got big stars by this, highlighted. In this, the love of God was manifested where? Toward us.
Yeah.
That God has sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might live through him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And say God. God said, I want to stay right there. Don't run. Hallelujah. In this, the love of God was what? Manifested toward us.
Yes.
That God has sent his only begotten Son into the world that we might what? Live through what?
Him.
through him.
Yes, through him.
See, so God, what God was doing, God is saying love was given. Not only love was given, love was identified. God identified love. Not only God released his son into the earth, but he identified him. Hallelujah.
Yes, yes.
Lord Jesus Christ, born of a Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. Hallelujah. But on the third day, God raised Jesus from the dead for us. Love identified. And God, when God talked about, God said, I want you to manifest, I want you to bring forth my love into the earth.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Listen, that we might live through Jesus Christ, live through him.
Yeah.
That he, his life may be manifested to the nations.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Then verse 10 says, in this is love. Not that we love God, but that he loved us. Here we go. And sent his son to be the propitiation of our sins.
Amen.
Meaning an offering. That propitiation is the Greek word hilasmos. It means an offering to appease, a satisfied, an offended party. To satisfy God the Father.
Yes.
Listen, it means both times of Christ's atoning blood that appeases God's wrath on all confessed sin. By the sacrifice of himself, Jesus Christ provided the ultimate offering for missing the mark for sin.
Yes.
Sin is simply missing the mark, hallelujah. Is a Greek word hamartia, meaning to miss the mark or miss our image. Hallelujah. As man, we never made it. Adam never made it to the tree of life. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He on this way but got intercepted. Sin came in. Hallelujah. So mankind had to wait, hallelujah, even in the place of Abraham's bosom until Jesus, the tree of life. The walking tree of life, hallelujah. Jesus Christ, the life, he said, the life giver, hallelujah.
Amen.
Life came, hallelujah.
He had to come, hallelujah, to restore mankind back to their image, back to his likeness, hallelujah. He's the restorer, to restore us so that we might not miss the mark again in Jesus' name.
Yes.
He who knew no sin became what? Sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God through Christ Jesus, through him. Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
The reason why God said might, because we had something to do with it. We can choose to receive and walk in it, and we can choose not to.
Amen.
But the work is done. Somebody say it's done.
The work is done.
Hallelujah. The work is done.
Yes.
So let's look at this. Let's focus in. If God identified his love, hallelujah. God identified him. He released his love to the earth. The word agape, hallelujah, the word love here in the text, it comes from the Greek word agape. It's a verb. Somebody say it's a verb. This is an action. This is not, agape is not a noun. The state is not a state. This thing is action. Somebody say action. Agape means actively doing what the Lord prefers with him by his power and direction. Agape loving, it is always defined by God, a discriminating affection which involves choice and selection. A discriminating affection which involves choice and selection. Listen to that. God determines, he determines the purpose for every person that's walked the face of this earth. God, his love, what he began to do, he began to distinguishly separate us and cause us to be holy, set apart,
yes,
distinguished among all of our brothers and sisters in Christ.
Hallelujah.
Not one person is the same. We may have a common situation. We may have a common call, but there's something in that call is specific just for you. All of us, we have different fingerprints, even in the natural. Even twins have different fingerprints.
Amen.
And God, that's what God does in the spirit. Hallelujah. Agape, when love comes, love says, I am the restorer of mankind. I am your prototype. Listen, I am the Messiah. I am your creator. And I discriminate and choose and select what I desire for my creation to be. Agape, agape is an example it's Christ living his life through the believer. Mm-hmm. Christ living his life through the believer. That's why Jesus says, I am the what? Way, I am the truth, and I am the life.
Yes.
No man can come to the Father except by what? Me. Jesus Christ even spoke to the Sadducees and the Pharisees. He said, before Abraham was,
I am.
My God. I just had to sit there and eat on that for a minute. I am. What is that? I am your way.
Yes.
I am your truth. And I am your life.
Yes.
That's why we don't have to bicker about, we don't have to be in competition one with the other.
Amen, amen.
Because God has a birthday present for every person.
Amen.
Hey, we don't have to, you know, some people have a Christmas tree, this and that, they sit around you. Wait, I didn't get a gift. Jesus said, I am your gift. I'm the gift for all mankind.
Yeah.
Everybody has a gift.
Yeah.
My God. Everybody has a gift, the love of God. So God is saying, my love never fails. What I have for you, listen, is successful. What I have for you is Jesus Christ being released from your life. What I have for you, it will never fail.
Hallelujah.
He's resurrected from the dead. He can never fail.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Agape. We begin to look at this thing. Hallelujah. Turn back two chapters. 1 John 2, 1 and 2. 1 John 2, 1 and 2. And God began to say, my little children, these things I write to you so that you may not sin. And if anyone sins, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he himself is the propitiation of our sins, and not of ours only, listen, not of ours only, but also for the whole world. Hallelujah. Not just for us believers.
Amen.
But he is the sacrifice for the entire
world.
Yes.
Jews, Gentiles.
Amen.
Yes. Now listen, Indians, Pakistanis, listen, it doesn't matter what culture, where you came from, he is your prototype. Jesus is your prototype.
Yes.
He is the firstborn.
Yes.
Jesus is the first begotten from the dead. Hallelujah. He's the one. Hallelujah. He is the way maker. He is your life in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go back to 1 John, the 4th chapter. And we're talking about a love that must be released. Love has been perfected. It said, 1 John 4, 17 through 19 said, love has been perfected amongst us in this, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment. Because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear.
Hallelujah.
Because fear involves torment. But he who fears has not been made perfect in love. Listen, we love him because he first what? Loved us. I'm thinking about worship, that last song. I couldn't wrap my mind around the song being connected to the message. See, what began to happen when God began to share forth his light, when God began to share forth his love for us, hallelujah, it's a love, the agape, is released. I believe in 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter, the chapter about love, God began, it's so much more than meets the eye, because God was saying the maturity of a believer, hallelujah. As we are known, we shall know, even as we are known. God is trying to mature the believer, you and I. He's maturing us.
Yes.
So that we might know what Daddy knows.
Amen.
About ourselves.
Yes.
That we may know, even as we are known. Hallelujah. God began to reveal the Christ and his assignment, his discriminating, his selection. I know who you are. But this is the type of agape that's going to reveal, uncover your mystery. Hallelujah. It's going to uncover Christ in you, the hope of glory. It's going to uncover some stuff so he can be revealed through your life. Hallelujah. So he marches, 1 Corinthians 13 marches through the whole chapter. Talking about what love is, what agape is, hallelujah. But it gets to a place of maturity, perfection. Somebody say perfection. So that we will have boldness. We will have boldness in the day of judgment.
Yes. Yes.
Pastor, what are we talking about?
Yes.
Because as he is, so are we in the world. As Jesus is, we conform to that image, what he shared with us. As he is, so are we. Huh? Amen?
Yes.
God began to, what happened as we get close to God, love the Lord, the greatest commandment, loving him,
yes,
with all of our mind, our soul, our strength. What does that mean? That means as we get close to him, as that scripture said in the psalm, it said, be still and know, hallelujah, that I am God. Be still. If you just Shabbat, just a minute, just practice having a Shabbat. We're talking about just a place of quietness, peace, where I can reveal myself to you. You'll know who I am. You will know not only who I am, but you will know who you are in me.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Somebody say, be still.
Be still.
This, what will give us boldness in the day of judgment is because after spending that time with the Lord, hallelujah, after he revealed himself to us, we walk in concert with him, hallelujah. We can walk in boldness. That's why Paul began to say, listen, I'm about to be poured out as a drink offering to the Lord. Hallelujah. I'm getting poured out.
Yes.
Yes. I'm getting ready to receive my crown that's laid up for me. Hallelujah.
Yes.
I fought a good fight.
Yes.
Listen, I finished my course.
Yes.
I ran a good race.
Yes.
Listen, but now it's time. Listen,
love.